Alrighty, boys and girls, welcome back. This is the Tone King here. We'll give you one of those bad boys right there. What I have here today, I have the Fender. Let's see if we could get that in there. The Fender Dave Murray Signature Series Stratocaster. Okay, so I'm going to tell you a little bit about this guitar. And I also want to tell you why I think that this design holds true way back from, dating back all the way to 1980. Okay, so we're going to go through a little bit of a Dave Murray history lesson here, and again, with concentration on this guitar, okay? So this here is it's a Fender, it's a Signature Series, okay? It's a black guitar, white pickguard, chrome pickup rings, okay, for the two humbuckers. We have over here, we have a DiMarzio Super Distortion. This here is a DiMarzio vintage single coil. And what we have over here is a PAF, a patent applied for DiMarzio pickup, okay? Three-way selector, okay? Vintage style tremolo, volume, tone, obviously the standard Fender jack, standard Fender bolt-on, okay? We have the cool signature in the back, vintage style tuners, etc., okay? And as you could tell, I'm personally a fan. I like DiMarzios. I'm a fan of DiMarzios, and this guitar really screams. Let's take a listen to the tones. Okay, so if you go all the way back, like I said, we're going to talk a little bit about Dave Murray now, okay? If you go all the way back to 1980, Dave Murray used a guitar that looked just like this. It was a Fender, okay? And it looked just like this, and I'll show you some clips, okay, from 1980. Here you go, okay? And if you go to 1981, you'll also see a guitar from the Killers album. You'll see Dave Murray used a guitar that looked just like this, okay? So take a look at these pictures here. Okay, and then as we go to 1982, you could take a look at the pictures from The Number of the Beast. And here we go, Dave Murray with the same looking guitar. So true to the original, okay? You have a guitar, and you know what? In general, okay, there's lots of artists out there, obviously, and lots of artists have lots of Signature Series guitars. In my own personal opinion, it's disheartening when a company, a manufacturer, comes out with a guitar that's completely different than the guitar that they've played, okay? This guitar, on the other hand, is true to its original design. Back when Iron Maiden made its first album cover, Iron Maiden, back in 1980, this was the exact same looking guitar that Dave Murray used. In 81 with Killers, he used a guitar that looked like this. In 1982, Number of the Beast, he used a guitar that looked like this. In 1983, Peace of Mind, The Trooper, okay? He used a guitar that looked just like this. We'll be right back. Okay, so there you have it. And then if you go on, 1984 it was Power Slave with Aces High. 1985 was the Live After Death. And then I have to be honest with you, ever since 1985 Live After Death, I kind of lost track a little bit. They came out with a lot of albums after that. There were some that were popular. Fear of the Dark was a great song. Can I Play with Madness was a popular song. But outside of that, I personally lost track. I'm an old Maiden fan. I like the old stuff, and that's why I love this guitar, because again, it's true to the original. If you check out the picks, this is exactly what he was using. Same type of configuration. Humbucker, single coil humbucker, Fender Strat, maple neck, black body, white pick guard. It's just an awesome looking guitar. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoyed this guitar. Hope you enjoyed the way it sounded. Hope you enjoyed my Maiden licks. As always, subscribe if you haven't done so already, leave a comment, rock on.